Pep, congratulations. 3 points. What did you make of the performance today?
We played really well. We struggled to score goals for the chances we create. With 16 shoots and 8 on target, so it's a lot in against this team. And after when you continue to do it and they start to put long balls to McBrien and second balls, and they play incredible well in the sides, the patience that they have, and after the crosses. But they had one clear chance, and no more than that. And incredible satisfied was so important. It's our third game in 7 days, all of them away. We travel in the Champions League, so it's so demanding, and people respond incredible well. And we got one game left, so we are there. We are in better positions now. And yeah, 2 games before international break, and after move on.
And the goal came from Kyle Walker, and you said this week that he's in the best form since you two have been together. We saw more evidence of that today?
Not for the goal. Of course, for the goal helped us a lot, but not just for the goal, for the fact that, his concentration, he understands every day much better what they want to do, what they have to do, the spaces where they are defensively. His physicality is no words to explain it. And he played almost all the minutes, and I know maybe he's not incredible, so happy for the fact that he scored against one team he loves a lot. He's a Sheffield United supporter. I remember we're in Championship and winning a playoff in the last, and always supporting the locker room. Come on, Sheffield, come on, Sheffield. So he loves this club. But for us, it was so important, the goal he scored.
100th Manchester City game, and you score against a club where you started. You wrote the script for today, didn't you?
I said it was football at the start. I'm happy to get on the score sheet and obviously get the 3 points, which I said was the main thing when we came up here today.
And it was important to break through that well-drilled Sheffield United defence just to get that advantage.
Yeah, they've done it for a number of seasons now. They're well drilled, everyone knows their position, and it's a tough team to come and break down. But luckily I came up with the goal through the bodies and got the 3 points.
And no celebration, of course, being a former ball boy and being an academy product of this club.
Yeah, my mum and dad live here, so if I celebrated they probably got a lot of stick. So, and I'm a Sheffield United fan, so I couldn't.
And that was your first away goal in the Premier League, and it happens in a place that used to be your home. There's an irony there.
Yeah, when I played for Aston Villa, my first game for Aston Villa was here, and I scored with my left peg, which was a rare goal as well. So I seem to like this ground. Hopefully, we'll never know in the future.
And Pep's liking your form as well. He's saying you're in the best form since the two of you have been together.
No, I'm enjoying my football. I think we've played a little bit of a different position this year, and I think it suits me and the team better. And I'm just, happy to be a part of the team.
A few nervy moments, because you want that second goal for the security.
Yeah, I think it's the football that we play. We don't sit back and defend a 1-0 lead. We always want to go and score 3 and 4, which for us defenders is a nightmare sometimes, I can assure you that. But it's great to get these 1-0 victories and a clean sheet on the board as well.
And you've got a defensive pairing next to you, centre-halves Ruben Dias and Marek Laporte. They look like they're gelling well together.
No, they've done fantastic, especially Ruben since he's come in. He's played a lot of games and, I think he's shown what a quality signing he is. But I think whoever steps in there, if it's John, Nathan, Eric, Ruben or Aimer, they're all going to, put in top performances.
Was there a little bit of a hangover at the start of the season with the Champions League campaign running into the next season pretty much? And have you picked it up now and you feel you're back on stride?
I think there was always going to be. I think for every team, they're probably not feeling as sharp as they want to be. But it's part and parcel of the game. It's just what we're dealing with at this moment in time. So we just got to get on with it. And hopefully when we get out on the field, it puts a smile on our face.
And it was, of course, a nice way for Kyle Walker to mark his milestone, wasn't it, Tim?
Great guy, great player. Top of his form, turned into a leader now, he's a real reference for the manager. He's sending him out there. I know what he's like in the dressing room. He will be a good example to the younger players coming in. He knows how to win. He left Tottenham to go to Man City to win things. He's done that now. He can share that information to the new players who are coming into the team. All of a sudden, for me, I think Man City look like a team who can win 1-0. They've got a defence now. Talked about that. Centre-half partnership. Talked in the interview there. Diaz, Laporte, fantastic. They don't get flustered. The goalkeeper looks far more calmer behind them as well. You've got Kyle Walker on the right-hand side who can get you out of trouble with his pace. Cancelo on the left-hand side. I think they look like they've got... Is there a better back four in the Premier League at the moment? Or back five? Who's fit? I don't think there is.
Is there?
I don't think there is. If they're fit, if they're all fit, the players who are fit at the moment, you know, Liverpool got a problem with Van Dijk, they all of a sudden are not clinical enough at the top end. We know that. So they have to keep clean sheets, and I think they can do that now because they've got the right personnel.
You know what's cool is it's actually not a back four, because it's a back four at times, but actually when they're in possession, it's a back three. And Kyle alluded to it there in his interview. He said, I'm playing a bit of a different position. So today you saw the left-back, Cancelo, when they had possession, he went into midfield. And really then it became a back three. So those three covered the whole width of the defence. Walker, Diaz and Laporte. And Laporte became the left-back. And I think that suits them, really, because that means you can get another player at the top of the pitch. Negates the fact you don't really have a left-back, whether it's Cancelo or Zinchenko. And with Tim, if you look at those three plus Edison, that's top, top draw. And without Van Dijk at Liverpool, you know, you'd say it could be pushing for one of the best defences.
Centre-half partnerships not working.
Yeah.
Chelsea keep chopping and changing.
Arsenal nowhere near.
Tottenham nowhere near. Jose's not got the right combination there. I think at the moment, there's something we're not used to saying about Man City.
Yes,
they look very, very solid.
Be able to win 1-0. If City can master that, then once they get the boys back at the top of the pitch, you know, then they'll be scary.
Yeah, well, the citizens, of course, smiling after that. And it was courtesy of a goal from Kyle Walker, as we've just heard. Let's have a look at it, shall we? Talk us through this one.
It was a great strike. I referenced it at half-time. I said he should score more goals. I truly believe that because he's got real good quality. He knows now there's a chance. When he drifts into the area there, he knows there's a chance. Good setup and a hit. Wonderful technique. But he knows when he drifts into the area, because the Sheffield United defence have gone so deep, he can get that 25 yards out. With his quality, he should do that more often.
Even before the game, he said he's been their best player. He was their best player in this game again. So Tim's right. I think his importance has just continued to grow. And from his days when he was with him, that he was, you know, maybe at times still learning the game, he's become a proper leader for this team, hasn't he?
He has. He's really grown as a person. Physically, he's a monster. Mm. I mean, he is so quick, it's unbelievable. I can't tell you. I mean, he's so strong with it as well. He can play on that right side of a three, a centre-back. He will play for England in the summer if he keeps himself fit. And I think he's realised now, he's 30 years of age, he's maturing. He thinks now more often. He used to give yourself tasks, put yourself in a poor position, so his pace and his athleticism gets him out of trouble. He don't do that anymore. He's saving his legs. He's not bursting forward at every opportunity. He's picking his times to go. No, I can't speak highly enough of the boy.
Well, lots of positives, as we've heard, about Kyle Walker. What does the manager make of his performance today? Here's Pep Guardiola. Well, I think you were both happier or more excited about that performance than Pep. I mean, he took the 3 points and we said that that's all that matters. He did reel off the stat, 16 shots, 8 on target. And one thing they did lack in the second half was a bit of cutting edge, Owen.
Yeah, I think back in the day, we would have said, you know, that second, third goal will come. But it doesn't really seem to come as much anymore for whatever reason. You know, it's just Kyle, and Tim's right, makes a good point. You know, he picks his spots better now, but that was one where, you know, you think with De Bruyne that could end up in the back of the net. That one's quite comfortable, really, I think. You know, not a huge threat, but they didn't create a ton of clear-cut chances. I didn't think so, at least, Tim. Did you?
No, not really. And they were not gilt-edged chances, which you're used to them creating. So, they're missing Leroy Sane. We've talked about that. They're missing David Silva. Offensively, they're not as strong. They've got no Aguero. They've got no Jesus, but they always find a solution. But they're picking the wrong options. Like there, Kevin De Bruyne, that he's never picks the wrong options. He's not got a relationship with Riyad Mahrez. There's something behind the scenes here. Listen, nothing personal. What a pass that was. Fantastic, gets him behind Raheem Sterling. But De Bruyne drifted out here because he was fed up playing and trying to combine with Riyad Mahrez on the other side. I mean, the body language between the two is not fantastic. I mean, Kevin, and he's throwing his arms around so much because he's frustrated. He feels like Riyad Mahrez slows the game up too much.
Yeah, I think we were watching the game. And I think De Bruyne is always there because he loves to be able to whip in crosses with his right foot. And I think he switched sides because the ball wasn't coming to him when he needed it. And it's interesting. I mean, I think the conversion rate, we look at the numbers, you know, today, this season under Pep, you know, they're obviously way higher normally. And I think it's just something when he gets to the cavalry back in, mm-hmm. in the Guerrero and Jesus, then they'll be different. But I'd be surprised if Mahrez keeps playing on that right-hand side, if his best player in De Bruyne is that frustrated.
Yeah. Right, time.